Before this, you must watch part 1 because in that I have described various types of auto analyzers. And in part 2, I will show you how semi automated auto analyzers are operated. I understand your problem that you don't get chance to handle auto analyzers during your training as well as during internship because auto analyzers are very expensive and you feel that this must be very difficult to handle. But that is not the case. These are as easy as handling your mobile phones. Just see this presentation. These various auto analyzers were described in part 1. And today we are going to discuss about how to use and operate semi-automated analyzers. In the case of semi-automated instruments, initial part of the procedure is performed by the technician. That means pipetting of the reagent, addition of specimen, mixing, incubating, and rest of the work, that means reading, calculating, graphing, reporting, and presenting quality control charts, etc., are performed by the analyzer. And just compare work of semi-automated instrument with fully automated instrument, and then you will realize that fully automated instruments do all this work. Well, let me show you now how semi-automated auto analyzer is used. So the first example I will take is of plasma glucose determination. Now try to understand system parameter for glucose determination. These are system parameters. Reaction type is endpoint, wavelength 520 nanometer and 640 nanometer, two wavelengths. Then flow cell temperature. Reagent volume is 1 ml, sample volume is 0.01 ml, incubation temperature is 30 degrees centigrade, incubation time is 10 minutes, and standard concentration is 100 mg percent, and zero setting with reagent blank. That means if there is one test, then you will require three tubes, one test, one standard, and one blank, and you will use 1 ml reagent in each, and sample added is 0.01 ml, same quantity of standard, same quantity of blank, that is distilled water, and after incubation for 10 minutes, then readings will be taken by the analyzer. And system parameters are controlled by the microchip inside the machine, and this was told to you in the you will get system parameters in the pamphlet of a diagnostic kit. When you open the kit, you will get this literature. Let us take example of one particular day when you have 8 patients and 8 patients plasma samples, and then you will work like this. First we will prepare working glucose reagent. Then we'll have a standard 100 mg percent. Then you will arrange test tubes and you will put up 10 tubes, 8 for the test, 1 for standard and 1 for blank. Then you will add 1 ml of glucose reagent in each tube and 10 microliter of each sample and 10 microliter of standard and 10 microliter of distilled water in the blank tube, which is not actually shown over here. After mixing contents of each tube, these tubes are incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 10 minutes. At the end of 10 minutes, colors will form in each tube due to enzyme reactions, and now it is necessary for you to use semi-auto analyzer to take further optical density readings and calculation of the results and patients. What you have to learn is the actual use of keyboard of any analyzer. Do you see these numbers and also various areas? To start with, you have to hit analysis code area. When you hit analysis code, you will get this window, test 1 to 32, 33 to 64, 65 to 96, and 97 to 128. And because glucose test is number 6, by using this particular arrow, you will have to bring this particular square on the test 1 to 32. Just see here, various numbers are attributed to various determinations, like albumin is 1, urea nitrogen is 2, glucose is 6. So when you tap this particular button number 6, machine is all set for glucose. For read blank tube like this. Hit this button, and this is the blank reading. Now introduce standard this way, and again hit this button, and just see how standard is introduced inside the thermocouple of the analyzer, and reading is recorded 100 milligrams per cent. Now take reading of test 1, introduce the contents of test 1 to the analyzer by hitting this particular button, and this is the reading you get, 115. Similarly, next test, reading of test 2, same way you have to read, and reading is 375 milligrams per cent. Like that, you take reading of various tests on semi-auto analyzer. You also can perform rate of reaction methods for enzyme determinations, and also are able to generate Lebesgue charts for quality control purposes by using semi-auto analyzers. And this work is again controlled by the macro chip, macro processor, which is present in the macro chip. Hello, I feel very happy to meet all of you on this YouTube channel. Today's topic is Biochemistry Auto Analyzers Part 3, in which I will give you information, basic information on how to use and operate fully automated random access autoanalyzers. Before this presentation, you must see part 1 and part 2 of this biochemistry autoanalyzer series so that you will understand this presentation better. So let us start and see this presentation. Well, first you try to understand the difference between semi-automated instrument and fully automated instrument. See, this sampler where samples are arranged, then the reagent carousel where the reagents are stored, and the reaction carousel. These three things are not present in the case of a semi-automated instrument. The meaning of random access analyzer means this analyzer will finish up all the tests of patient number 1, followed by patient number 2, followed by patient number 3, etc., etc. Now let us see how fully automated analyzer works. For that matter, we will take today's example. There are 3 patients, patient 1 for glucose and urea nitrogen, patient 2 for ACPT and HUT, and patient 3 for cholesterol, triglycerides, BUN, LDH and CK determinations. Barcode labeled specimens are then arranged on a sampler. Barcoded reagent bottles are arranged on reagent carousel at specific allotted numbers. Keyboard is used to program analyzer for various tests. Keyboard is used to program the analyzer for the following very important aspects of the various tests. All test system parameters, then reagent position numbers, sample position numbers, calibrator position numbers, standard position numbers, control sera position numbers, etc., etc., and very important, information of the patient, name, sex, age, and various tests. Touch screen buttons of a specific analyzer, and by reading this, you can understand the specific use of each one of them. For example, this is for test parameters, this one for patient entry, this one is for quality control purposes, this one for reagent entry, this is to access previous data, this one is for standardization, this one for service purposes, this one is for maintenance, and after entering all this information, you have to just hit this button, run test, and auto analyzer will start working and will finish up all the tests. By using these buttons, you will get idea about individual test parameters. This is how patient's data is entered. Patient number 3, test, ALT, AST and ALP, sample number, position number, sample type, and then sample ID and date, all this information. For emergency samples, use this emergency mode and then sample number and position number. Select test for the emergency sample, this blue color. Register the emergency sample and also register the batch mode. Robotic arm pipette functions, then the spectrophotometric unit reading functions and report producing functions are precisely controlled by the microchip microprocessor like this. Who requires glucose, creatinine and HGOT determinations. Just see here, the robotic pipette will pick up glucose reagent. It is added in the reaction tray cuvette, washed, creatinine reagent, added in second cuvette. Pipette tip is washed, then azote is separated, added in the third cuvette. Then patient number 1 sample picked up, added in the first cup for glucose determination, second cup for creatinine determination, and third cup for SGOT determination. And the tip is washed, and now once the incubation is over, glucose reading will appear, creatinine reading will appear, and SGOT reading will appear. And this is the report. See the functions of the robotic arm pipetter again. It not only pipettes specimen and reagents precisely, but it also performs the function of mixing in the reaction chamber where cuvettes are placed at precisely incubation temperature around 30 degrees temperature. The reagent is pipetted, specimen is pipetted, mixing is performed, and the tip is washed. It's on the turntable carousel maintained at constant incubation temperature, where specimen and reagents are mixed, and then the turntable turns till the time incubation temperature is complete. Like this. On this screen, reports are displayed. Look at the screen for SGOT determination. Cuvette position is 7, reagent 1 position is 3, incubation time in seconds 60, absorbance reading is mentioned over here, then measurement time in seconds 180. And this is the result, 33.33 international units. This is the filter information at 340 nanometer. Readings were taken and readings reported in terms of absorbance. Here, the position of the reagents is indicated, whether reagents are insufficient or exhausted. This is how the rate of reaction is displayed graphically. The test results are displayed like this. Report print out, SGOT 40 international units, creatinine 1.3 milligram per deciliter, glucose 110 and cholesterol 100 milligram. For more information, refer to page 121, chapter number 5 of this textbook. And thank you very much, and don't forget to subscribe, like and share my channels on YouTube. Now the question is, what are the various ways to find out reliability of working of an autoanalyzer? They use internal and external quality control programs to find out whether an autoanalyzer is giving accurate report or not. For that matter, various calibrators and quality control serum samples are used. Calibrators and quality control serum samples are placed on the sampler at various positions such as number 1, 5, 10, 15, etc. And from the results of calibrators and quality control serum samples, LJ charts, Levigenin charts are produced, and by using Westgaard rules, it is possible to find out reliability of any autoanalyzer. Kindly refer to page number 132, chapter number 5 and experiment number 5.1 for information on autoanalyzers, and chapter 6, page number 169 to get information on levigenin charts, and page 174 for Westgaard rules. And yes, also see our videos on levigenin charts, Westgaard rules and quality control in a clinical laboratory. I hope you will like this compiled video on how to operate an autoanalyzer. Next time I will bring you one more interesting educational video. And yes, do not forget to subscribe our free Praful Godkar educational channel and hit bell button so that next time you will get message of our new educational video. Thank you.